Remember, our update function takes a single year as an argument, and with this year, we have to filter our data. In this case, we'll actually be filtering our nested object. Remember, when we grouped our data by year, the nested object had its key property set to the year, and in our filter function, all we need to do is strip out the key and compare it to the year we want to filter by. In this case, the nested object actually has its keys as strings, so we first need to convert the string back into a date, pull the year out, and compare it to the year passed to our update function. And the filter function works just like a map, except for instead of returning every element of the array it's called on, it only returns ones where in our accessor function, we return true. In this case, true will only be returned for the elements D, where the key is equal to the year passed to our update function. And now that we have the correct data filtered, we can begin updating our map and the circles drawn. To do this, we'll use data binding and the special enter and exit selection that we covered in the last lesson.